God. Lord, I thank you. You made us needful. Giving thanks unto you, Lord God. You made us need to be partakers. You made us able. You made us able to be partakers of you. Of the inheritance, Lord. Partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Yes, we are made partakers. You made us able, Lord, to be partakers, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. For we are complete. We are complete. We are complete. Yeah. Oh, God, you effectually work in. You effectually work in. You effectually work in. You effectually work in Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Scriptures which pertains to the ministry of reconciliation. In your meditation book, you will find scriptures under the heading, our call to reach the lost. There's certain scriptures that we can place your meditation book under that particular head and our call. These are the scriptures that's admonishing us to fulfill our call in terms of reaching the lost and the world. Just begin to reflect on that. We have to get our minds, amen, set on the focus that we have. And we do that simply by beginning to meditate those scriptures. After you begin to meditate, and you begin to pray those scriptures. Begin to use these scriptures in prayer, you begin to articulate, you begin to release and come into agreement with God, amen, in this particular area, amen. This is how the desire, the motivation, and the zeal that we need is kindled. And we have to find some way to get in that mode to do what God wants us to do, and we begin just simply by meditating the scriptures which pertains to our call to reach the lost. That makes us more aware that this is our primary responsibility as believers to fulfill the work that Jesus is here to do. We are here today in his stead. So in your meditation time, amen, just spend time focusing on those scriptures. This is in your meditation book. Meditation book is this book here. Amen. This is the meditation book here. And whatever you want to accomplish, that should be the focus of your meditation. Amen. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? Amen. Otherwise, it's very difficult to get in that mode unless you're meditating and you're focusing on, amen, the scriptures in that particular area. So just meditate on those scriptures. And the second area under the ministry of reconciliation, we'll try to make these books available. I know that we've had them for years. What happens as time goes by? Amen. Now, the other area would be you're created into Christ for good work, unto good works. And there are scriptures which shows us that we are his workmanship, we're created, he's supposed to be performing those works, same works that Jesus did, and those works are the works that we are called to do. But these scriptures show us that we are called to do those works, and he has given us the ability to do them. So we have to focus on our call. We have to be convinced that we are called to do something. Not to just sit around and just come and go, but we are called, amen, to carry out the works that Jesus has called us to do. Amen. The Bible says that he's called us out of darkness into this marvelous light. And that call is to show forth his, amen, glory, to show forth his love, to show forth, amen, the power. Amen. All right, so created into Christ into good works. Now, this is an area that I draw a lot of scriptures from, and I pray them. I speak them out a lot loud in prayer, because you're energized when you begin to speak. You're speaking about created into Christ into good works. See, that's that pattern. You have a whole lot of scriptures that pertains to us being created, amen, in Christ for good works. And those scriptures really energize you. And it talks about made able ministers. We're made able ministers. So we can kind of focus on scriptures which shows us that we are created to do good work. This is the reason why we're saved. The scripture says, the main scripture under that particular head, it says, Ephesians 2:10, for we are his workmanship, created into Christ unto good works which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. Then another one says, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared unto all men, teacheth us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Amen. All right, that shows that we were created specifically, amen, to be zealous of what? Good works. And it goes on and on. And that really challenges your heart. And the third set of scriptures ends with this. This is a faithful saying, and these things I will that thou affirm constantly, that they which have believed in God might be careful to maintain good works. In all things showing thyself a pattern of good works. And let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works. So all of those are scriptures that can motivate us that we want to get in that mode that we're going to begin to go out and perform these good works. And there are some things that we got to put in place, amen, but we can do what we can do now. But our motivation should be, we're called, amen, to do something. We're called to do something. Now, until that gets embedded into our spirit, our prayer is going to be in vain. Amen. Why should you come out and pray to do nothing? Amen. Now, the last part out of that particular heading, it says, faith without works is dead. That will even steer you further. Amen. So that means that we got to what? We got to do something. We got to, amen, add works with our what? Faith. Amen. Works means that we got to what? Do the works. Now, it's easily understood. What do we do? We just follow the example of Jesus. That's in the other book that we have. Following the who? Example of whatever he did, that's what we, what? You might not do it in the same measure, but what? Basically, that's what you want to do. That's the direction you're going to be what? Here. Amen. And that really challenged my heart. Faith without works. That's a whole passage. All of this is in the meditation book. So I want you to understand that it's not enough for us to come out and just be in prayer, but we got to have some foundation that we're working from, amen, in order for our prayers to grow and to be meaningful, and for our prayers to, amen, to lead us to the success and victory that we are seeking, amen. Now, the other heading, amen, made able ministers of the new covenant. I love to just speak these things out in prayer. I'm an able minister. Boy, that energizes me like no, at big time. Amen. This is one of the scriptures, not by might nor by my power, but by, it's not by power nor by, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord. Amen. The spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me. So these scriptures are showing us that God has what? He has made us what? Able. We have in us everything that we need, but we got to what? We got to come into agreement with that. We got to begin to speak that. Amen. And so, you know, I think that prayer should be more than just a session where we're begging. Amen. I think that prayer should be a session of time that we should what? We speak out, amen, and come into agreement with our words. The thing that God says that he has what? He has made us. How else will these things become reality to us? We got to what? We got to begin to what? Pray them, speak them, sing them. Can we sing them? Amen. Whatever God said you, amen, that he's made you, sing about it. Sing it. Amen. That motivates me like nothing else does. Amen. It's talking about, I give you power and authority against unclean spirits to cast them out. But let's just sing about what he's done. All right, now. This one I was speaking out this morning, of his fullness have all we received in grace for grace. As many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. This is under the heading, he has made us able ministers. So your prayer time can be very full, complete, and meaningful if you make it that. Amen. So we have to come to the point where whatever we are seeking, whatever we want God to do, whatever we want to see manifested, we have to begin to speak these things out in prayer. Amen. And even go beyond that. Amen. When you speak them out, just get excited about it and praise it. And praise him for it. Amen. Can we praise him for it? Amen. Can we praise him for it before we get for the reality of it become real? Amen. Praise God. So we praise him for it. Amen. Now I'm going to go a little further, Brother Kirk, and then you sing it. Amen. After you sing it in English, sing it in the spirit. Amen. Whatever it sounds like in English, say it in the spirit. Amen. Amen. So we don't want to just waste time and just do the same thing over and over and over. So this year should be a year that we should strive to perfect, amen, our prayer life. Our work and call as ministers of the new covenant. So we just want you to be aware And everything you need is in the Word, and all of these scriptures and promises and provisions God has made us, these things we are to what? We are to take hold of them and begin to use them, amen, to perfect that which concerns us, amen. Now, scriptures like this, and of this fullness, have all we received in grace for grace. How does that make you, what impact can that have of his fullness I've already received? The Holy Spirit giving us everything that pertains unto life. We've already got that, but it seems like we don't have it. Amen. It's going to always seem like you ain't got nothing going until you begin to what? Acknowledge and what? And amen. And what? And come into agreement with. You're going to have to speak it and say it. Amen. It's got to come out of your mouth. And when it comes out of your mouth, it becomes what? Powerful. Of his fullness have you received. And great. Of his fullness. So we're looking for something to happen way down here, out here. God to do something tomorrow, today. I need this, I need that. And the scripture says, of his fullness we have already what? Received. And when you begin to confess what God has already what? Provided you. Given you everything that pertains unto life. And get extremely, how many believe you can get extremely excited about what God has said he has done for you? And when you become extreme, this is like healing school out at Raymond. When they become extremely excited about what God has already done for them, then their healing always becomes a reality. It becomes a reality. But it doesn't become reality, amen, until you do that. And I have found that great source of victory and great source of strength when you can just acknowledge God in prayer. Amen. All these blessings and promises, we won't say nothing about it. But just like a wife, I mean, you know, working her behind off all week and all month, all year, and you don't ever, I mean, you just sit down and enjoy it and don't say nothing, don't acknowledge it. That's a bad way. That's a good way to get in bad, bad relationship with your family. Well, that's a bad. That's a good way to get, amen, to strike out in your home, right? That's a good way. So we have to acknowledge everything that God has done. The more you acknowledge all of these things and speak them out, then the more life will be released into you. Amen. Now, that's one of the grand scriptures of his fullness I have received in grace. Amen. This is a good one too, Romans 5:17. They which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life. That means that you're going to be on top of everything that you touch. Why won't you speak it if you want to be on top? Why won't you sing it? Amen. Somebody said, I can't sing. Y'all don't even think about how good I sing. If I can make a tune out of it, I'll make a tune out of it in a minute. If I can put some harmony to it some kind of way, I'll do it every time. And a minute or two, boy, it just lifts you. Ooh, glory, boy, you feel just massa moshe ta. Woo, koshimishe ta, nemoko rikimena. It just gets you all, amen, released in the spirit, and you just can go in any direction you want to go almost. Amen. So just begin to. I receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness, and I reign. I reign. I'm in control. I have power and authority. I can direct my life. I can cause whatever I say happen. No weapon formed. No weapon formed against me. So this week, we're going to be focusing very heavily. And this scripture here says that not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything of ourselves, but our sufficiencies of God. Who have made us able ministers. Amen. Now, if you never hook up with that and begin to speak it and say it and get excited about it, it will never become reality. It will never become reality. He's made me able ministers. I'm an able minister. My sufficiency, you can very easily say that because my sufficiency is not what? Of me. My sufficiency is of what? It's of God. Amen. How many believe that we can get something out of this week? Amen. And for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do. He gives you the ability and gives you the will and the ability to do whatever he has called you to do.
Why can't we say it?
Amen. We're going to say it this week. Amen. Amen. I'm not going to be just saying, Lord, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Bless us, Lord. Whatever you are focusing on, that's the thing that you should be speaking. Now, can we do that this week? Amen. Then we can go on. You complete in him. He's made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance, the great inheritance. Has he given us the ability to partake of it, to receive it? Has he given us that ability? Sure he has. Amen. And, oh God, there's so much in here. For instance, unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Here's the last one. For this cause also we thank God without ceasing, because when we receive the word of God, which you heard of us, we receive it not as word of man, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in them that believe. So the word of God is effectually working in me. Lord, your word is effectually what? Working in me. Now, what do you believe? What will happen? What will happen when you begin to say that? Put your heart into it. Really begin to say it in your heart. What will begin to happen? God will begin to what? You begin to what? Effectually work. Amen. God can't do anything without you participating. Amen. You got to participate in it. That's what we're going to be doing this week. According as his divine power has given us all things that pertain unto life and unto godliness. So we want to, because we go further, after we perfect that, maybe we'll give ourselves a week on that. They're standing in the gap, making up the hedge. Those are some scriptures that we need to begin to focus on, and some other prayers that areas that pertain to prayer. All right, I'm going to shut off. Amen, Brother Dean. Amen. I know you a lot of things coming to you in your head. You want to say a word this morning? We're just so glad to see you. Amen. Yeah, hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Amen. How many others? We just want you to express whatever you're feeling in your heart this morning. Amen. I don't want to express anything that you might have on your heart this morning. How many believe that this is the right direction? How many believe this is the right direction? Amen. What do we want to God? We want to, amen, we want to what? Step out and start what? Doing what God has called us to do. No, there's a period of preparation, but we got enough to do a whole lot already. You're right. So we just got to, amen, release what we have. Find a way that what we have can be released effectively. And I believe that God will begin to work, amen, mightily through us. Let's all just stand, closing out, prayer. I have the Lord lead you.
Father, we thank you this day that you've made. We rejoice, we're glad in it. God, I thank you that every joint, every part of the body supplies. Lord, I thank you for every leader, every member of this church, that you are stirring good works. Not just faith, but faith with works. Lord, I thank you for the release and the stirring of the gift of God that is in us from the laying out of hands. The fire of the Holy Spirit, Lord.
Jesus.
God, we don't go out on our own strength or our own ability or our own ideas. God, I thank you for the impartation of wisdom and knowledge, direction of the Holy Ghost. And Lord, we receive it now. And Lord, I thank you that it will spread throughout this congregation, Lord, by your grace, that there will be great grace upon this church. Great grace.
Great grace. Great
to do the work. Great grace to be a light, a city upon a hill that cannot be covered. And I thank you that grace, God, it oozes and it permeates our very life and our family and our household. In the name of Jesus, our relationships, our work, the things that we put our hands to every day. Lord, I thank you that it's not compartmentalized, but But God is released into every area, God, of our life and of our community. In Jesus' name, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise.
All
the knowledge,
yes,
that you are God and we're not.
Yes.
Lord, we submit ourselves to you this morning, to your work and to your leading. In Jesus'
name. Thank you, Lord. Glory. God bless you this morning. We just didn't want to go too much longer than an hour. We appreciate you coming.